Hey, my name is Matthew McQuade, and in 2008 and 2009, I did the Revolution Hawaii program. I just want to take a few minutes to share with you some of the tips that I learned along the way. Maybe you're interested in Revolution Hawaii, maybe you have some questions about Revolution Hawaii, or perhaps you're going to be doing Revolution Hawaii in the next year. But I just want to share with you 7 tips that will help you to be a successful Revolution Hawaii member. Tip number 1. Be prepared to be challenged in 3 different areas of your life: spiritually, mentally, and physically. Spiritually, you're going to be going through the scriptures. You're going to be challenged. You're going to be reading books that help you understand more about your Christian faith. Mentally, you're going to be challenged in your different conversations that you have. They may have you thinking one way about something and you may have a different opinion. And physically, you're going to be going all the time. Now, contrary to popular belief, you're not just going to be surfing all the time. You're actually going to be out in communities. You're going to be doing a lot of work, a lot of volunteer work. So be prepared to be challenged. Tip number 2, come with an open and humble heart and a humble attitude. Now, you're in a different culture. Hawaii, although it is part of the United States, it's completely different, especially if you've never been there before. Just imagine going into somebody else's house. It's kind of like that. You want to show respect. You want to listen. You want to take off your shoes when you go into their house. So come with an open and humble heart and a humble attitude. Tip number 3, understand that 1 year, it seems like a long time, but it goes by really fast. In 1 year, you get a lot of different experiences. And although at the beginning it may seem like things are taking a long time to begin and it feels like everything is just dragging along, once you get into the flow of the routine and you start building relationships with people, the year is gonna go by really fast. So don't miss out on anything. And take advantage of the opportunities that you have in the year. Now, you're going to be faced with a lot of challenges, but you're also going to be given a lot of good opportunities, so take advantage of those. Tip number 4, you're going to be living in community. Now, this may seem like one of those situations like, oh, that's not too bad of a gig, but in reality, you're going to be faced with a lot of different personalities. People are going to maybe get on your nerves in some ways, but there's a lot of good benefits to living in community. You're going to build relationships and friendships that are going to last a lifetime. I can think of several people from when I did Revolution Hawaii that I'm still in contact with, and we still talk about our experience and we stay in touch with what's going on today. Tip number 5, do your soaps. If you're not familiar with what soaps are, you'll learn once you're in Revolution Hawaii, but I'll tell you really quick, it's a daily time of devotion and getting in the scriptures and journaling and discussing what's going on in the scriptures. In Revolution Hawaii, you go through the Bible in 1 year, but stay on top of your devotions. It'll benefit you in your relationship with your leaders, but it also benefit you in your own personal spiritual life. Tip number 6, and this, if you're going to be joining Revolution Hawaii this year, maybe you can start this right now. Start raising your money early. One of the challenges that I had was I was trying to raise money while I was in Revolution Hawaii. I was writing letters and selling stickers, but it was difficult because it took my eyes off of some of the ministry that I was involved with. But if you can get a little bit of a head start, maybe a month or two or even 6 months in advance of raising some of your money, you'll be able to really focus in on the ministries that you're involved with. And finally, tip number 7, allow the different leaders and the different teachers that you're going to meet along the way to invest into your life. Allow them to speak into your life. Maybe they're going to speak some challenging things into your life, but allow them to speak into you. Maybe there's some areas of your life that need to be corrected. Discipleship requires that we listen to somebody, that we are open to the different teaching, and that we discern what God really wants for us in our lives. And I just want to leave you with this, that for me, Revolution Hawaii 10 years later has been a very, very important foundation in my Christian journey. I've continued to apply many of the different disciplines that we learned along the way in the prayers, in the Bible reading, in the relationships and the outreaches that we participated in. And I can tell you that my relationship with Jesus has continued to grow.